Hey everyone, welcome to this tutorial on Apple Pages, one of the very best pieces of software that you can use to create complete documents absolutely for free. In just a few minutes, we'll show you how it all works. Okay, so let's move to Apple Pages over here. When you open it, you have several options, like starting from a ready-made template. You can choose from many types here. For the purpose of this tutorial, let's simply start from a blank document. When it opens, you see the new document in the main preview. If you want to open other documents, just go to File, Open, and browse through your files, including Word documents in DocX format. Alright, so this is the main preview. We get several tools at the top on the toolbox we will see through this tutorial. On the left and right, you get more features grouped into panels, which we will also explore. Now, before we start, let's adjust the document settings by going to Document on the right. This opens a panel with several document options. As you can see, my system shows centimeters by default. If that's not what you want, go to Pages Settings, then to Rulers, and change the unit used across the project. So, if you prefer inches, switch it here. Up here, we can adjust the template size as you need. Adjust the page orientation and whether to include a header or footer, as shown here. Just remember to turn these on or off if you want to see them. You can also set margins for the document body. Here, saying Hello World placed right below the footer section. On the right, margins control the distance between the body text and the page edges. Now, let's start writing the document body. As you type in, when you press the Enter key, you simply start a new paragraph line, and so on. So each of these paragraphs has its own settings, like the distance from the page margins and other options we will cover. You can recognize each paragraph by spotting the Pilcrow symbol when it's selected. You can keep typing across the page and new pages will be added automatically as you go. Okay, now let's add some footer notes. For example, Beauty of Sunset as title, and here, for instance, the page number. This way, the number updates on each page. You can open the document section again to fine-tune the margins for the header and footer. Now, let's see how to edit the text. You can select a whole paragraph, just a word, or even a single line, and then open the Format panel. Up here, you can apply pre-made paragraph styles. Under Style, pick a different font family for the text, change the general look, or simply adjust the size. You can also fine-tune advanced settings like character spacing to space out letters, or apply effects like outline or shadow. You can also set the font color, control the text alignment, and adjust spacing between lines or between multiple paragraphs, either before or after. Just use Command and Z to undo anything if needed. If you switch to Layout, you can adjust how the selected paragraph is structured, like changing the number of columns. You can also set indentation either for the first line or the entire paragraph from the left or the right. Farther down, you can apply paragraph borders. These are useful for adding separators, either on top, at the bottom, or between multiple paragraphs. And you can adjust the color, size, line style, and more. Another very useful feature is the ruler, located under View, Show Ruler. This helps adjust indentation and spacing. If we select a paragraph, we can use the yellow marker and the right marker to change spacing. These adjustments also apply when selecting multiple paragraphs. To move only the first line, Use the top part of the left arrow marker. Next, let's make lists. We can type a dash and enter text. Then press Enter to continue. Letters and numbers also work. For example, like this video and subscribe to this channel for more helpful content. Please do that to support us. Now, select the list and adjust its spacing again using the ruler. Then, go to Format, Style to change text formatting. Under Bullets and Lists, choose Symbols, List Types, and more. At the top of the page, there is the toolbar with different options. For example, if we place the pointer here, we can go to Insert and add a page break. We can also insert a footnote from Insert, Footnote, or even add equations. For example, y equals x. Here's how it looks. You can also add hyperlinks. Select text, then go to Insert, Link, choose the web page, and paste the link you want. Now let's add a table from the Table button above. Let's start from a table with 4x4 cells by default. You can always change the number of rows and columns from the table corners. Just double-click on a cell to start typing and fill the table as needed. Move the table by using the top left button, clicking and dragging as you like. Right-click the same button and select Cut to delete it. We can also insert charts from the Chart button at the top. Pick one, then go to Edit Chart Data to fully customize it. In this case, we'll enter some simple data about sunset duration. With the Text button above, you can insert separate pieces of text. These are called text boxes, since the text is confined within a box. Double-click to type in. Click outside to apply changes, and click and drag to place the text box. To link two independent text boxes, click the button at the top on both boxes, then use the right arrow to connect them. This lets the second box continue the text if the first runs out of space. We can also insert shapes in the document. You'll find lines, shapes, and more under the Shape button. Just click one, then drag it where you want, and adjust it using the nodes. You can also insert audio, video, and photos. Simply drag them from any folder directly into the document. Apple Pages offers several tools to manage large documents when you start having many pages. For example, starting from page 2, you can go to Document, then to Section, to create a new section from that page. This way, if you apply a new background color, like yellow, it will appear on that page and all following pages. Another helpful feature is adding an index for this long document. This works if all your titles and headings use the paragraph styles listed under Format. Then, place the cursor where you want, like at the top of the page. Then go to View, Table of Contents. Make sure your titles and headings are detected above. Then go to Insert Below. Now select the table and use the Format panel to adjust its appearance, just like we did with regular text. You can also switch to Table of Contents to customize its format. For example, by choosing which headings are titles to include or exclude. To hide the index from the left panel, go to View, and then select Document Only. Another useful option is searching for specific words in your document. You can use Command and F to search for a word, and also enter a replacement if needed. On the left, you can switch between a simple Find or a Find and Replace. This is how it works. Now, let's see how to manage elements outside of the standard text. First, click on any element to select it, then drag to move it around the page. You can also use the nodes to resize or reshape it, or open the Format panel on the right to fully customize its look. The available options change depending on the selected element, so they may vary. For example, with a text box, we can go to Style to quickly change the font, add borders, or apply a shadow effect. Switch to Text to adjust its appearance, just like we did with the standard text. You can also go to Arrange to manage the object's placement in relation to the rest of the document. If Object Placement section is locked, simply disable the top button we used earlier to connect the text boxes. Then, choose Stay on Page to keep the element fixed as you type. Or select Move with Text to let the element shift if you add or remove text lines. Under Text Wrap, you can change how the element interacts with the surrounding text. By default, it puts space automatically. But you can choose specific wrap types, line around, above, or below, or none, which means a fully overlapped content. If elements overlap, you can change their layer order. Go to Arrange and set which element must appear in front or behind. You can also adjust general settings manually, like size and position. More options appear with different elements. For example, selecting a chart opens chart settings you can edit. Selecting an image lets you go to the Image section and use Edit Mask to crop it. You can also apply color corrections. You can add comments to help review your document. Just select text or an object, then click Comment at the top. This lets you leave notes you can view later by clicking on the comment square. To hide them when no longer needed, go to View and choose Hide Comments. Now, let's go over saving and exporting the document. If you see the word edited at the top, press Command and S to save. To export, go to File, Export To, and choose the format you want. This lets you export as a PDF to share or print, as a Word file with password options, or into other available formats. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and official website to discover more free and amazing tools for your Mac.